The bloke I feel sorry for in footy right now is the coach of the Blues. From a football perspective, he's in an invidious position. There's a review coming up shortly, but he's being let down in many ways by his playing group.
Yeah, it's a roller coaster for him at the moment. The effort wasn't there on the weekend. It was up the week before. They were terrific against St Kilda. The problem has been all year. Their main issue has clearly been the ability for teams to walk through them from one end of the ground to the other. Their defensive system as a whole team is just horrible. So you continually come back to that and go, rightio, what is it? Is the coaching, are they coaching the right systems? Are they not educating the players in the right manner? And then they can't get consistent effort, which falls back on the coach always.
Yeah, so I'm on the effort train.
Yeah.
This is what I'm looking at here and why he's in... Yeah, it's an obvious trouble and no one's relishing it. I mean, this has been going forever and a day, Jared, because you can't move a whole playing list out, so someone cops in the neck. But the issue is, how can you go from an effort perspective against St Kilda that was satisfactory, it was clear, it was obvious, we all watched it and you can see it, and then you come up against the team who are coming off a 98-point hammering, like a humiliating hammering at the same ground less than 6 days later. So what your role... Apart from all the other stuff that Brownie's talking about defensive systems and all that, your role is to get them in a headspace that doesn't happen. Because all the Gold Coast Suns are sitting back going, and I use this term all the time, they didn't ask the question.
Not at all.
Of Gold Coast.
166 is witch's hats, to put it into perspective.
Yeah, so that's a coach thing. And as hard as it is for him, and, you know, that gets sheeted back to the coach. And we might say, the players are fruitcakes and up and down. Well, yeah, they probably are. But his ability to coach beyond this year rests with his ability to get that intensity level up to something.
And you always look at to the coach, because you just would have to think it's a lack of understanding of what it takes to deliver week in, week out. And that can be a number of things. Like, I think there's a selfish underbelly within that group. I think there's a level of, it's just not important enough at this stage of their careers, wherever they're at as individuals. There are a few that are the gems that just know no other way, like your Sam Walshes, who just show up every week and don't know any other way but to give great effort every week. You've got a few of those. The trouble is, the weight of numbers, which is the case in the negative at the Blues, is that it's just not important enough to too many.
So will it change if a coach changes? This is the bottom line. So you can imagine, Jared, what the messaging is.
Of course.
Before the game.
The messaging doesn't change from one person
David
to the
Teague's
other
not,
that much.
He's not David Teague's not stupid. He knows what needed to be done, but he wasn't able to get him to do it. Will it change with a new coach?
We don't know that, Gary, but there's a lot of people know the song, but they don't know how to sing. And David Teague may know the song. He may just not be able to sing, or the people who are listening aren't interested in what he's selling. Tom Morris joins us again. It's a tough week for the Blues because Thursday could well be D-Day.
Yeah, I think it is, Jared. If the decision hasn't been made already, it will be made on Thursday at this board meeting where the board will be delivered the review that's been going for a couple of months now. Now, my understanding is that senior management at the club has already seen this review. It's damning on a lot of fronts, not just David Teague, but also other senior people within that football department, including the head of football and assistant coaches and others as well. And that will be delivered to the board on Thursday. What's interesting is there's 48 hours between this board meeting and then when Carlton are due to play Port Adelaide on the weekend. Now, that leaves David Teague, I think, as a dead man walking for two full days. And the expectation is early next week, probably, if not, regardless of the result, but if not, then the week after round 23, he'll lose his job and his papers are essentially stamped. And I think everyone inside, in fact, I know lots of people inside the club know that. The board is just waiting for this review to drop for good governance purposes, but David Teague won't be coaching next year.
Well, that seems as if it's a fait accompli right now, but for mine, if they've made a decision on Thursday night, as difficult as it is with Mark Murphy's 300th celebration coming up on the weekend, he needs to be told. He is owed that.
Absolutely.
You shouldn't be waiting for this to leak out in the press. I mean, the press are already talking about it, we're talking about it, but if the decision is made, and I mean it made in principle, then tell him.
The good club is honest and upfront. They treat their people with respect. They give him the option.
Exactly.
Otherwise, an assistant coach has to come in and become the caretaker. So we don't know what the result is, of course. But it's a big evening for Mark Murphy. Yep. He's been a tremendous servant. It shouldn't be overshadowed by rumours and innuendo over that weekend's game.
So they're talking Teague. These are the names. And Lloyd and the fitness, whoever. What's the what's Chris Judd's role in all this been? Is it?
I don't think he's there anymore.
Okay,
why? He hasn't been there for months.
I don't know why.
Well, I think
what's a footy director's role? To give support to the senior coach, is to talk to the footy manager, to lend you his undoubted wisdom and energies and business acumen to guide them through what's been an awful situation. And what, you tell me he's not there?
No, he hasn't been there and probably hasn't been there for most of the year. I mean, the reality is they should have gone and got...
Has he stepped down at the end of the year and put his position up for...
No, he's long gone. He's gone for
months. So did they replace him?
They haven't replaced him.
So they've had no support?
They did bring in John Worsfold, either temporarily or for a month or so. So there was some support there for David Teague. But clearly it's not a good enough position to be at when your footy manager is not there for... Sorry, your footy director is not there
for... This has to go deeper and wider than the coach, though. I mean, the uncertainty is club-wide at Carlton. And it has to be because I'm not sure David Teague's been given a chance, really. Like a genuine chance. When you consider inherited all the assistant coaches... So none of those changed when the senior coach changed. He's had COVID interrupted seasons.
Footy director just packed up and left.
Like, you talk about setting a bloke up to fail. If this is indeed the way it's going to play out.
How much impact can the footy director have, though, on that in terms of, you know, we're talking about big jumps in performance?
Ask Jason Dunstall how much he had at Hawthorn.
Yeah, but he was the CEO, he was the interim CEO as well.
He was the footy director there for first. Mm.
I think, when you've got
a coach who's under enormous pressure and you're turning around looking for some help and some assistance, the footy director's that person. I don't know whether Juddy's... Why? He needs help through this in the back half this year.
Yeah, but Juddy wasn't able to give it and the Blues didn't replace Juddy. I think they talked about it. I think they brought in John Worsfold, but quite clearly it may be of coincidence that all of a sudden his job is on the line on Thursday night. And the news doesn't get better for David Teague. Tom, you've got more news on Alistair Clarkson.
Yeah, the goalposts have clearly shifted ever since Alistair Clarkson became available. Senior officials inside Carlton acknowledge that. Lots of discussions about whether Alistair Clarkson will coach next year or not. I know that people at Carlton believe that they can get Clarkson next year. Now, Luke Sayers is also close to Nathan Buckley. Jeff Walsh's role in this whole thing is very interesting as well. He was part of that review panel alongside Matthew Pavlich. Jeff Walsh is very close to Nathan Buckley. He's a big fan of Brad Scott as well. And I understand that Luke Sayers has spoken at least informally and probably just that to this point to Nathan Buckley about what he's doing next year and what his plans are as well. So it's pretty clear that while Teague is the coach, the Blues have been privately looking ahead to 2022.